Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andre from the GUI. Today I'm going to show you how to create cloud brushes. First, create a new document, go to File and click New. So I use for the width 340 mm and for the height 210 mm, and I use color mode RGB. So first, create a new brush, choose the ellipse tool and create a circle and fill this circle with black color and choose non-color for stroke. And next, create a scatter brush from this circle. Go to the brushes panel and click new brush. Choose scatter brush. Okay. And set the size to random, spacing to random, and scatter to random. And choose colorization method tints and click OK. So next, choose the paintbrush tool and create a simple line. And now I'm going to change the settings of this scatter brush. So make a double click on the scatter brush and change the size a little bit and spacing. And a little bit scatter. So, like this. And click OK. Choose Apply to Strokes. So, next you can delete this line. Press the Delete button on your keyboard. And you can delete this circle. So, next, choose the paintbrush tool and create a shape like this. So, and create a second shape. So, if you want to close these gaps, so you can change again the settings of the brush. Make a double click and try to change the spacing. So that's fine. Click OK. Apply to strokes. And next you have to expand both clouds. Select both clouds with the selection tool. And now go to object and click expand appearance. So next step is very important. You have to delete all these rectangles. So choose the magic wand tool and click on this rectangle and press the delete button on your keyboard, or you can go to edit and click cut. So select all. So these are my circles for the clouds. So before I'm going to create brushes from this shape, so if you want, you can move some of the circles, choose the group selection tool and move some of the circles. So you can scale some of the circles. So if you finish, select all the circles, click on this little circle by your layer, and now go to Pathfinder, open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Unite. And next you have to delete the inner path, so choose the group selection tool, deselect all, click on this white area, and now click only on this inner path and press the delete button on your keyboard. Okay, next I'm going to create two copies of my cloud group. So drag this cloud group down to the new layers button and a second copy, and fill this first group with black color. The second group with gray color. Like this, and the third group with a little bit darker gray color. So that's fine. And now move the black group a little bit down and to the right, and the second group up and to the left, and I'm going to change this gray to a little bit lighter. So that's fine. And next, select all cloud layer groups, click on this little circle. And now open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Merge. So if you wish, you can delete some of this little shapes. So I delete with the group selection tool this black shape and select this little black and press the delete button on your keyboard. And so next I'm going to change this light gray to black, so select these shapes and now choose the eyedropper tool and click on this black color. And next choose the group selection tool and select the small shapes and this black shape and open the Pathfinder and click on Unite. So next I'm going to create brushes of these two clouds. So choose the group selection tool and select the first group, this first cloud, and now open the brushes panel and go to the brushes panel options. You can click on this new brush, or you can choose this button, new brush, or you can drag this cloud into the brushes panel, so like this. And I'm going to create an art brush, click OK, change the brush scale options to scale proportionately and change the colorization method to tints. Okay, and make the same with the second cloud. So you can click on this button, new brush, add brush, and change options to scale proportionately, and change the method to tints, and click OK. So create a new layer and choose a paintbrush tool. Choose blue color for stroke and try your brushes. So next I'm going to create some more brushes. So next you have to choose the group selection tool, and I start with this light gray shape, select on this shape, and now hold down the Alt key to make a copy, drag your mouse. So next select this black shape and drag this down by holding down the Alt key and select this shape, hold down the Alt key and drag, and so next I'm going to rotate these shapes a little bit. So choose the selection tool, but it's better you choose the group selection tool, or you can choose the free transform tool. If you use the free transform tool, you have to hold down the control key and click, deselect all. Hold down the control key and click on this shape, and now rotate it and fill this shape with black color. Not the stroke color, the fill color. And create four new brushes. So choose the group selection tool and click on this brush. Go to the brushes panel and click on this button, new brush, add brush, scale proportionately, and method to tints, and make the same with the other shapes. So next choose the paintbrush tool and combine all these brushes. So I start with my cloud brush, choose blue color for stroke and draw a line. So make this a little bit darker and take the second brush. So next you can use the other brushes and with light blue color. And next choose dark blue and try the other brushes. So you can use the same brushes for dark blue and light blue. So I try, for example, this brush. So if you draw this brush from left to right, and you can use the same brush if you draw from right to left. So choose light blue color and use this brush. Draw this time from right to left. And the same brush with that dark blue color. Draw this time from left to right. So again, if you wish to draw the same, use the same colors for light blue and dark blue, you have to store the colors. So first, I'm going to create a new layer and a new cloud. So first, choose a color for the basic cloud. So take your first cloud brush and create a line. So change the color for example this color. So store this color in your swatches panel. Click on this button, new swatch, or go to the swatches panel and click new swatch. You can call it clouds. So this is your new color. So next you have to expand this cloud. Go to object and click expand appearance. And now you have to store the light blue. Choose eyedropper tool and click on this light blue. Store this fill color. New swatch. Clouds 1. And next choose a dark blue color with the eyedropper tool. And store this to clouds 2. Okay. So next delete this cloud and now start with the paintbrush tool. Choose first the cloud brush and my first color for stroke, not for fill. So next choose one of this line brushes and choose first the light blue. Next choose one of the other brushes and choose the dark blue color. Sorry. So next, delete this cloud and create a big rectangle. and apply a gradient for the fill color. So change the angle to 90 degrees and set dark blue and light blue . So please lock this rectangle and choose a paintbrush tool and use the cloud brushes . So I'm going to use my swatches, select all these clouds and apply this blue color for a stroke. So next deselect all and use the other brushes. I start with the light blue. And the dark blue color. So you wish you can create more clouds. So, and last, you can store all these clouds as brushes. So, choose the group selection tool and I start with this big cloud. Select all shapes, this cloud, and now go to the brushes panel. Click on the new brush button, choose art brush. Choose scale proportionately and click OK. So you can group this cloud. Go to object and click group. So I continue with this cloud. New art brush. And group this cloud. So we can select the whole cloud. So next choose a paintbrush tool and use your cloud brushes. So you can change the draw options. Go to the toolbar on the left side and click on this button and choose draw behind. Oh, sorry. Make this rectangle invisible. And next, move the background rectangle so that's fine and change again the drawing mode to draw normal. So if you wish, you can apply a gradient to all these clouds. So first select all clouds, click on this little circle by the cloud group. So next go to object and click expand appearance. And next you have to select only the basic blue color of my clouds. So choose the magic wand tool and open the magic wand tool options and enable fill color and set the tolerance to 0 and click on this blue color. Next choose the eyedropper tool and click on the rectangle background to use the same gradient. So I'm going to hide the edges, go to view and enable hide edges. So if you wish, you can change the angle. And if you wish, you can change the color. So go to the dark blue color and make a double click on it. That's it, I'm finished. Thanks for watching. If you liked this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.